Hello, my name is Yonis. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create our simple calculator for a decorator in order to identify the areas that he or she needs to paint and find out how much it will cost to purchase the paint, or even how much he or she has to charge the client. What I have done here, I've created a new form in Visual Basic. So by going to File, New Project, select Visual Basic and select Windows Format. Name your software appropriately and click OK. Then add a number of labels. So here, by using the toolbox here, I've added 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 labels. And that's the labels here. I've also added 3 radio buttons. So by actually go to the radio buttons here. Added 3 radio buttons. I've added one checkbox, and I've added 9 text boxes. And two buttons. I've also added a panel here, so where I have you want an undercoat. I've added the panel, and then I've added these elements here. If your objects are like that, and then you can just drag them over to your panel. Then you just move the panel and all the objects will move as well. Okay. Now, the next thing we need to do is name our labels appropriately. So by using the Leszczynski Riddick name conversion, we're going to name this label here LBL title. This label LBL ceiling, this label LBL wall. Now, it's not important, very important how you're going to name them for this project, but make sure you name them, you give an appropriate name to all the labels that is clear to yourself and to all the programmers. Make sure when you name them, you do not put any spaces. Once you have named, you compose this video, once you have named all your labels appropriately, you can actually play this video, continue playing this video. Okay, now we have named all our labels. We are going to name all our text boxes appropriately. So in this case, my suggestion to you is name the text boxes similar to what the names I have given to my text boxes, because it is important for you to actually have the correct names here, because the code I will provide you with later on is based on these text boxes, of the names of the text boxes that I have here. So here, the first text box here on the ceiling, the length, I call it TXT, C, capital C, length. Then I've called the next, the ceiling width, I call it TXT, capital C, width. And the area, I call it TXT, A, for area, ceiling, lowercase, so only the A is capital. For the wall, I call it TXTW, height, only the W is capital. So for the width, I've called it TXTW, width, only the W is capital. Then for the number of walls, TXT, number, capital N, of, capital O, walls, capital W. And for the area, I call it TXT, A, capital A, wall. Then the total cost, I call it TXT, capital T, total cost. Total cost with undercoat, I call it TXT, total cost with undercoat. So I just capitalize T, capitalize C, W, and U. Then I've named my radio buttons appropriately. So RB, economy. RB standard with capital S, RB economy with capital A, RB Standard with capital S, RB Luxury with capital L. The text box, I call it CB checkbox, CB capital U for undercode, capital Y for yes. Okay, then I've named my button DTN refresh, with only capital is there, the only capital is R, and BTN exit with capital E. Right, you might have to rewind a couple times this video to name your objects appropriately. And we're ready to get started once we name our form as well. So our form needs to be called FRM Decorators Cal, followed by your name if you wish. The Decorators Cal you can put on the label text section, you can put your name afterwards. By using the properties for its label, you can change the for color. Let's change the for color here to anything you wish. Just going for the white. Yeah. You select the object. You select change the for color. You select in the font. You change the font size, you turn in the bold section to true, the width, if you want to make them italic as well. By selecting the form, you can change the background color to anything you wish. And by selecting the panel, you can change the background color for the panel to anything you wish. Make sure the background color and the text are contrast colors. Okay, once you're happy with the colors, we can now start doing adding the code. It is important for us to remember the names that we gave to these text boxes, because we're going to call these text boxes. Now, first thing we need to do, we need to apply an event. Now, the event we're going to apply is a mouse move event. So we need to apply the mouse move event within the form. So it doesn't really matter where the user is. As soon as I move the mouse, these values, the calculations will take place for the total cost, etc., etc. Now, how do we do this? We're going to select, click once here on the form. We're going to click on the little lighting bulb here, and then we're going to scroll up or down until you find the mouse events. And then we're going to say on mouse move. We're going to double click here to add the mouse move event. And the mouse move event has been applied for us. If it doesn't take you straight away to the code view, you can go manually. When you double click here, if it doesn't take you straight to the code view, just click here on the code view and you will be able to see the private sub for mouse move. And this is on the form. Okay? Now, next thing we need to do is we need to basically calculate these two values, multiply these two values and add the total here. So this text box, let's go back to the properties here. This text box, make sure the properties is this icon here. This is the events, this is the properties. So if we scroll down to see the names, call TXT A capital A ceiling. So I'm going to go back to my code, I'm going to call it, I'm going to say TXT A ceiling dot text is equals to, and I'm going to calculate the value, I'm going to open brackets, of the TXT. Let's go back to here, find out what the name of this text box is. TXT C length. So TXT C length. TXT C length dot text And then I'm going to say times the value of the txt c width dot text. So txt c width dot text is the name of this text box here. Let's double check txt c width. So basically what I'm saying is this: when somebody moves the mouse of the form anywhere on the form, I want this text box to contain the total of these values multiplied with each other. So let's play. So as soon as I move my mouse cursor, this value becomes 0. So if I put here 2 and 2, for 4, for 3, okay. So I can actually move, I'm multiplying these two values. Now, the next thing we need to do, let's stop it, is multiply these two values, and then the total of these two values will be multiplied. We want to multiply them with this, with the value of this text box here. And then the total needs to be displayed here. So the text box here is called txt AWOL. I'm going to go here, and then I'm going to say txt AWOL dot text is equals to, I need to open a bracket now, because I need to create two calculations, two different text boxes to multiply them, and then outside this, I need to multiply the total, this value here, number of walls, which is txt, number of walls. So I need to multiply it to the value of txt, oops, the value, open brackets, txt number of walls dot text. So here we need to put the value, we need to calculate the value of the txt. Let's find out the name of this text box. Txt w height. So txt w capital W height dot text, and then we'll say, I'm going to close the bracket here, and then we're going to say times the value of txt width w width dot text, and then we need to close another bracket here. So the reason why, can you see here this bracket here, this bracket is closing this calculation first, because we need to do this calculation, we need to multiply this value here times this value here. Once these two values are multiplied, we need then to multiply the total with this value here. Now, because here by default I do not have any values, and it's a bit, the calculation here is a bit more complex than it was here, because we now have multiple calculations. We have now the second time. We need to make sure that these values set by default to zero, because if we don't, let's have a play here. It shouldn't actually work here. If I move my mouse cursor, okay, it's moving. But sometimes if you're moving your mouse cursor, it might actually come up with the error message. And this is the error message because the value here is not set, specified. So in this case, so as a good practice, if you receive any error message here, what you will need to do is select these text boxes and add the value of 0 on every single text boxes, because we're talking about calculations here. So by default, we want to have the 0 value here, just in case you receive an error message. Okay. So if you press play now, you will not be able to see the error message because the values here are 0. So if we say here 2 times 2 equals 4, let's put 3. Oops, let's put 3 here. So 2 times 3 is 6, that's correct. And if we put here 2 times 4 equals 8, but 8 times nothing is nothing. So if we put here 2, so 8 times 2 is 16, okay? That's good. Now, the next thing we need to do, we need to be able to select one of these options, and based on the option that we select, we have the total cost here. Now, the total cost will come based on these options here. So, how do we do this? Stop that. Now, so here, when somebody clicks on the economy, so we need to put an event, and the event will be on click event. Mouse down. Yeah, mouse down. We want to add up these two numbers and multiply these two numbers with the actual 0.45. So this text box, let's go back to properties here. This text box is called TXT A ceiling, and this text box is called TXT A wall. So here we want to display the total. This, the total text box is called TXT, TXT total cost. So we're starting here with a TXT total cost, and we say TXT total cost dot text is equals to TXT A ceiling plus TXT A wall. Now, comes up with underline because we need the values of these two text boxes. So we're going to say the value, I want the value of the TXT A ceiling, which is the text field. So we'll say text plus the value of the TXT wall, which is the text field. Okay. So the total cost is adding up these two numbers. So we're going to have to put them now again in brackets, and then we're going to say times 0.45, which is basically the economy option here per square meter. So we want to find out how many square meters are in total, and then multiply the square meters by 0.45 pence. And then the total cost will show us how much money the client has to actually pay. So let's press play. So we're going to say 2 plus 2 equals 4, 2, 2, and 2, 8. So 2 times 2 is 4, 2 times 4 is 8. That's correct. And if I click here on the economy, I've got here £5.40. So £5.40 will be the total amount the client has to actually pay. So now I'm going to close that. I'm going to go back to the code. I'm going to copy this code command that I just put it here. And I'm going to repeat myself to the next one here, to the standard option. I'm going to click on the lighting bulb. I'm going to click on mouse down. Here, mouse down there, mouse down for the standard, which is £1. So we're going to say £1. And then we're going to pay, we're going to add, we'll mouse down the luxury as well. Double click here, mouse down, paste, is £1.75. So this here is £1.75. So now if I put here, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. Okay. The economy will cost me £5.40. The standard will cost £12. And the luxury will cost £21. Now, we need to select, find out how much the total cost will be with undercoat. Mouse move. We're going to check if the value here is true. So the name, let's go to the properties, and the value, the name of this box is CB, under code yes. So we're going to go here on the mouse move event. So we're going to say, if CB, okay, dot checked, If that's true, then we want the calculation to take place. I'm just lazy, I'm just copying this. But it's not the total cost, it's the total cost loop undercode we want. So we'll say txt total cost loop undercode is equals to the value txt a ceiling plus txt a wall times, let's say, 50 pence. So we want to charge 50 pence more, okay, if the checkbox is selected. So we create this if statement here. Let's put some programmers' comments here. The following statement will check if the checkbox is ticked, and it will charge the customer 50p per square meter. We can put here some more programmers' comments. We'll say the following code will calculate the and find out the square, the size of the ceiling. Here, Control C to copy, Control V to paste, the size of the wall. So here, the following code will calculate and find out the total cost for economy. Let's copy that. For this will be the luxury, the standard. And 1.75 is the luxury. It is important for you to put the programmer's comments there to make things more easy for you to understand and remember as well in the future. Anyway, so what we're going to do, we added a tick box here. This tick box is going to check as soon as the mouse is moved on anywhere on the form. It's going to keep checking if the tick box is checked. And if the tick box is checked, if the checkbox is checked, it's going to change the value of the total cost with undercode, the value of this text box, by actually adding these two values together. So these two values together and multiply them by the 50 pence, 0.5. Let's play. So by default, nothing happens here. So I've got here 2. If you see an error message, make sure you put here zeros. So let's go back again with practice. So because we're talking about price here, so total cost, let's go to the text field, let's put zero here. Let's go here, put zero here as well. Okay. Let's put again. Else check so if it's checked, else we're gonna say txt that one, this value equals 0. So let's play again. So let's put here 2 2 2 2 2, then put economy, and if we tick this box and we move over, we have 6, and if we check is 0, but it has to, the mouse cursor has to move away from the common panel. So what we might want to do, oops, let's stop that. What we might want to do is move this code, copy this code, and put exactly the same code on the panel. Go to the lighting bulb as well, again, and go to the mouse tab, and then we'll select a mouse move, double click it, and paste this code here. So we paste the same code twice. If it's checked, okay, show us this, else show us only this, so once only the total cost. Let's go back here, instead of zero, it's going to show us the total cost only. So let's play. Let's put two economy total cost, then we'll click here, total cost is on the report, and then we'll change the numbers here. Automatically, things should take place. Okay. So this is the total cost with undercoat. This is the total cost. We change to luxury or standard. This value is changing. This is the amount of money that the client has to pay. Finally, we need to actually apply some code for the exit and for the refresh. Do this. We need, when somebody clicks on the refresh button, we want all these text boxes to be clear. Now, we're going to double click here, and then we're going to say TXT. So here we have all the text boxes that we added values to. So let's start with the TXT length. So Control C to copy. TXT length dot text equals 0. Text equals 0. A couple of lines. So this TXT length, TXT C length, TXT C length. The next one is TXT C width. Copy that. TXT C width. I'm going to copy this and paste it here. Control C, Control V. Just gonna copy this and paste it a few times. The next text field is that one here. Gonna highlight this, Control C to copy, Control V to paste. The next one is that one here. Gonna highlight this, Control C to copy, Control V to paste. The next one. Control C to copy, Control V to paste, the next one, I'm just going to double click the highlighter, Control C to copy, Control V to paste. There's an easy way, I'll show you afterwards, but if we don't make it difficult with that, if you want to remember things, Control V to paste. Control V to paste. Control C to copy. Control V to paste. Control C to copy. Control V to paste. So I'm changing all my text boxes to the value of 0. Okay, so I'm resetting them on mouse click. So when somebody clicks on the PTN refresh, all these text boxes will have a value of 0. And we have finally the checkbox. Now we'll say checkbox, which is dot checked equals false. Okay, so we change it, the value of text box to be equals false. So if I take this value here, then I put some numbers down. Okay, so we have values here everywhere. Now if I click on refresh, the checkbox is unchecked and all the values change to zero. Finally, we need to add the exit button. Now we're going to say, I'll go here, double click on the exit button, and we're going to say exit. Press exit and the application closes. Okay, just to summarize, we create the decorator's calculator by using Visual Basics. We added a number of different events, a number of different labels, and a number of different tools, objects in general. So we added options, checkboxes, text boxes, labels, buttons, and panel. We can also add, finally, to make our software a bit more attractive, we can go to the icon finder. It's one of my favorite sites. This is free images here. So I'm just going to create, I'm going to download one of the pictures. I'm going to download a picture which has PNG as well as icon. So I'm going to go back, find a picture which has an icon, that's it, a PNG. So I'm going to save this and save the icon as well. I'm going to go here. I'm going to copy both of the images and I'm going to put them onto my desktop here. Them there. I'm going to select the form. I'm going to find the default ugly icon and change it to what up here. And I'm going to put a nice picture box here. Let's move this spread down. We'll go to the letter P for picture box. I'm going to click on the play. Change it to stretched. Stretch image. Choose an image. Import. I'm going to go to my pictures. Click OK. Set the picture here. Switch it. Yeah. Let's put the picture here. All the other stuff, highlight room, put it down. By using the arrow keys on the keyboard. Okay, so if we press play, have everything in place. Let's change the color of the buttons as well. So let's put stuff appearance, flat appearance. Let's put a border of 3. Style, oops. Style. So standard split pop-up. No. Let's put a standard. Let's change the background color. Change the font color. Change the font bold. Change the bold to true. decides to run this. It's a bit big. 15, that will do. So let's change that to 15 as well. Let's make it bold. And let's make the color of the logo greenish. Let's click web so we have more colors. Oops, now we go on the full color. So, full color to make it in white. Oh, bright. Let's go to bug on color. Yeah, at least now, so green, red, and the display calculator works fine. Undercode and stuff, and now finally, we can go to build solution. Oops, before we build the solution, let's go back to my project, and we're gonna select an icon from the desktop. So I put my icon here. So now I'm gonna go to find, build, publish, decorator scale, and I'm gonna browse my desktop and decorate scale, open and finished, and put the other calculation in the setup file. I'm gonna double click it, then follow the installation process. It's finished, and now as you can see here, the calculator software is here, and as you can hear, my wife is shouting, the dinner is ready, it's time for me to go to eat something. Okay, so that's how you create in the decorator software, from nothing to something, to a full software application that can be installed on every single Windows operating system. It doesn't really matter the version. So decorator software is there, it's installed on my system, so I can close this software here now, I can save everything. And close this, and I can actually go here, I can actually zip this folder, and I can sell this to clients. I can download it online, so if I run it, I can put here the numbers, and economy, yes, with undercode, refresh, and exit. So thank you very much. I know, Ileana, the food is ready. Okay, thank you for watching. Bye.